Hi, my name is Jesse Eisenberg, and you have logged on to ZayZay.com.
Come in close, because the more you think you see, the easier it'll be to fool you.
¿Qué pasa con mi gente? Yo soy tu amigo Zay Zay, and welcome to another banging interview. Today, I have the privilege of, you're gonna be jealous about this one. I have the privilege today of being able to hang out with none other than Jesse Eisenberg, who's starring in a brand new movie called Now You See Me. How you doing today?
Oh, good, Zay Zay, how are you?
I'm good. Tell us a little bit about the movie, for those that don't know yet.
Sure, so the movie is about four of the greatest magicians in the world who perform these bank heists as their magic, where they steal money from corrupt businessmen and distribute the money back to people who have been stolen from.
Right.
And so the FBI starts tracking them, trying to figure out how they're performing these incredible bank heists.
Right. You have this knack of picking these really interesting kind of characters to play in interesting roles. In great movies also, 30 Minutes or Less and Zombieland and Social Network, it goes on and on. Is there a formula to that? Do you sit there and say, okay, well, this is what I'm looking for in a character, and if it doesn't meet these criteria, then next.
Yeah, a little bit. I try to select a character to play that feels like they can exist outside the movie. So most movie characters are kind of there just to further the plot along,
Okay.
To deliver information about where the thing is hiding. But I like to play characters that feel like they have a real personality, that feel like they have a life outside the movie.
Right.
And then also if I can bring something of myself to it. When I read the script, I was doing a play in New York and I was going on stage every night and kind of feeling nervous about it. And then they sent me this script and my character is the most confident stage performer in the world. So I felt like this would be a good opportunity for me to live out the fantasy of being a great stage performer.
Ladies and gentlemen,
for our final trick,
we are going to rob a bank.
On the count of three, you will be teleported through space and time to your bank in Paris. One, two,
three.
You've written at least two plays, mm-hmm. And acted in them as well.
Mm-hmm.
What's the draw for that? You're obviously a talented writer. Mm-hmm. Why not make them movies? Why make them plays?
Whenever I sit down to write something, my stories always take place in one room, and they usually have two or three utensils as props. So I can't, it would be a really boring movie to watch, because you're just looking at the same couch. But on stage, it's so exciting, because the audience is sitting there, and they're there's a couch on stage, it's so thrilling. But if it was a movie of a couch, you would get really bored, you'd probably go out for more popcorn or something.
Okay. Well, what's your favorite type of acting then? Obviously, you do stage, you do screen, you do small screen.
I like acting on stage because it allows you, when you do a play, you get to do the whole story every night.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're in a movie, they shoot it just little bits and it's all out of order. So you'll do the first scene of the movie 5 weeks into it, and you'll do a scene in the middle on the first day. And so it doesn't give you the feeling of momentum, But when you're doing a play, you do the same thing every night.
Right.
And so it's kind of it's a little more exciting, I guess, to be able to do that whole story.
Very cool, very cool. If you could tell us, because I want to get to know you.
Okay.
If you could tell us one thing about yourself.
Yeah.
That people would be surprised to find out.
Oh.
Pick a good one. What would it be?
Probably about the bodies stocked under my crawl space. No, they're not here.
Oh, they're not here.
They're in my house.
Then that's fine.
They're in my house. I guess people...
That's why you like it cold.
Yeah, exactly. Well, very good. That is a reference to a joke made prior to the interview. And I have to say, a very good reference.
Thank
that
you
was very
much.
Clever.
Thank you.
Yeah, unfortunately, no one saw it. So
that's
does it
fine.
Exist? No.
All right, they're wrapping me up. Do me a favor. Look into the camera. And in 30 seconds, sell me this movie.
I can't do that.
You can do, come on, you could try.
That's so crass.
Can you try?
I feel like I'm selling a mattress or something.
That's fine.
Okay.
Sunday,
really soft,
Sunday, Sunday.
And, but also it's good for your back. I don't know. Let's see, the movie is about magicians and they do these amazing, I really am doing this? This is absurd.
You really do?
Can you do this thing?
I could do it with you.
Okay. We'll do dueling.
We'll do dueling.
Promotions.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Split screen. Here we go.
Okay, you start.
All right. You guys definitely have to go see this movie. It's an all-star cast starring this man right here.
It's really not that good.
It's pretty good.
You really
should
go.
You should go. You're going to enjoy it. It's fun. There's magic. There's tricks. Lots of visual illusions. You're going to
you'll probably see it in a movie theater and your shoes will get stuck to the floor because somebody
fine.
Will put their gum
it's
there.
You know what? But if you yeah. like gum, then you can pull the gum out. See, glass half full, man.
Right, good.
Go see Now You See Me. It's in theaters this week.
Whatever this grand trick is, it was designed a long time ago. And I believe that what's about to follow is really going to amaze.